Welcome back to Black History Month, a Fox 8 special presentation.
What happens when a woman takes power? What
happens? Groups like the Burke Singers, an a cappella group at Winston-Salem State University, shared their gifts in venues across the country. During slavery, hymns like the one you just heard were a roadmap for freedom. During the Civil Rights Movement, they were a rallying cry for change and hope, and they've influenced nearly every genre of music.
Fox 8's Chad Tucker met some of the members of a group who had inspired music for generations. He met one of their sons, and in fact, they've been called the godfathers of R&B.
And they got their start right here in the Triad.
This little house in Winston-Salem was once a gathering place for music royalty.
Sam Cooke, Ray Charles, Stevie Wonder, James Brown.
They came to meet a man named Loman Pauling. He and his group, the Five Royales, created a distinctive sound.
They started R&B.
Each night before you go to bed.
In the 1950s, the Five Royales had a string of hit records.
Baby Don't Do It is really their first hit.
And like many in their day, they started out in gospel.
They went to Apollo to do a gospel album. When they got there, the people from Apollo heard them and wanted them to do secular music. So they switched over to secular music.
Loman Pauling was a self-taught and talented musician.
My grandfather made a guitar out of a cigar box. That was his first guitar.
His style would rock the music industry.
My father on guitar influenced Jimi Hendrix, Eric Clapton. James Brown patterned his first group after the Five Royals.
Pauling wrote hundreds of songs, but one of the best known was influenced by his wife, Elise.
Each night before you go to bed, my baby.
And he wrote the song on the back of an envelope. And my mama didn't hear it till he played it for her, and he told her, "This is for you."
Sadly, Pauling passed away in 1973, at the age of 47. But his impact on the music industry was recognized when he was inducted in the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame in 2015.
This is dedicated to the one I love.
And you can find more about the Five Royals on their Facebook page.
It would be hard to find a more respected authority in the field of hip-hop than Patrick Douthat. People around the world know him by his stage name, The Ninth Wonder. He teaches at Duke University, Harvard University. He's also the artist in residence at North Carolina Central University. He's a rapper, a Grammy Award-winning producer, and recently he was inducted into the North Carolina Music Hall of Fame.